I feel like I haven't let people in enough. I feel like I haven't told my story because the timing wasn't ready yet. You know, I've heard a lot of people say, when they see me, they envision that classic kid in high school that was good at everything and seemed to have that perfect life, and I don't, you know, honestly, it's completely different. And to create this life, I had to overcome a lot of things, so I think that's the biggest misconception of me.
We're in Riverview, where I've spent majority of my life. I didn't have a traditional family life. I didn't have a traditional childhood. My parents, for the longest time, they had a very toxic and violent relationship.
My mom had a drug issue, and my dad alcohol, but my dad lived that rock and roll lifestyle. It was not normal for a kid that was in a perfect world.
I used to babysit myself there, you know? I used to stay up all night, eye out the window with a BB gun, just waiting for my parents to come home when my mom would be gone weeks on end, and my dad would play and get home from the bar at like 4:30, 5. My dad was sitting down watching television after they had been arguing, and my mom, shot him on the right side of his chest, like, collapsed his lung and put him in a very tough situation. Obviously, I'm assuming there was drugs and alcohol involved in this situation, but my mom was furious and wanted to leave, and my dad didn't want her to leave. I just knew, like, the life my dad lived, and I just thought maybe, oh, some random guy at a bar shot him. And then you find out.
I think what I saw as a child had a lot to do with the fact that, to me, showing how you feel is weak, and it was a protective mechanism that I created in myself. And I've been shy to show who I am because I don't want there to be weakness.
Staring at this and just realizing, like, such a life-changing event happened. It's a crazy, crazy feeling.